Adobe Camera Raw has just got a huge update. We can have a look at it right now. It's version 17, which is inside Photoshop 2025. Now, there's some features in here that are unique to Camera Raw that are not even in Lightroom. Let's have a look at them right now. And to update, go to the Creative Cloud app. You'll see the icon at the top of the screen or the bottom of the screen if you're on Windows. Then we're going to click on Updates, and you'll see all the applications that have updates available. If you want to update Camera Raw, we're actually just going to update Photoshop. We can see here, version 26, you click Update. My suggestion is don't remove the old version because you can run both at the same time. So have the new version, make sure it doesn't have any bugs, like run it for a week or two and make sure everything is working the way you want. And then you can safely remove the old version by just simply going in here and choosing the uninstall. So let's just click continue. Let's look at the main three ways of getting images into Camera Raw. One is to open them in Photoshop. Then we just choose filter. And then we can choose the Camera Raw filter. Now this will launch Camera Raw, but one of the things you'll notice is the image size and the crop are not available. The other way to open an image is to choose File Open, and then we go directly to a RAW file, and then choose Open. Now this will also work from Bridge. If you open it in Bridge, right click and then choose Open in Camera Raw. This will open it in here where you see all the options are available, including the crop tool. So you might not see some of the new features immediately. You need to enable those. The way to do that is to go up to the gear in the top right corner. And then we're going to go down to the technology previews here inside of Camera Raw and then turn them on. Click OK. Now we need to restart Photoshop in order for this to take place. All right, so here's a rocket launch. And as you can see, there is a lot of noise in this image. This is shot at an ISO 25,000. So let's see what we can do to reduce that noise. The AI noise reduction has had some updates. So let's go under the detail. And under detail, we have the option to choose denoise. So right now it's enhancing the image. And look at that. That is absolutely amazing. Now we have the ability to roll it back if we want. If you don't want to have quite so much noise reduction, you can choose the amount that you want. So this only works on the RAW format. However, it's been expanded to include more types of RAW, including also the iPhone, the Pro RAW, and also the RAW from the Google Pixel phones. So let's have a look at this on a different type of image. So here's one at drag racing at night, and we can see there's a lot of noise going on in here. Now, one of the things you'll notice under the detail too is that we have the ability to do RAW details, which works particularly well on X-Trans, such as a Fuji camera. Super resolution, which we've looked at before, we can apply that on here, and we can also do the denoise. Now, notice as we choose one of the detail option, the other options are grayed out, so we can choose one or the other. Another thing you'll notice, this is applying this into the original RAW file and not creating an additional file for this now. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. If you're familiar with profiles, this changes the way that the RAW files are converted so we can view them and work with them. Now, profiles are really powerful. They're very different than presets. Presets just move these sliders. These profiles actually change the way that these are interpreted from the RAW data. So the new option here is the Adobe Adaptive. Now, this works really well for things like HDR. For example, this is actually a merged HDR image. Watch what happens when we choose the adaptive profile. Look how that image just really just kind of comes to life. And this is before we've made any adjustments. So we can go ahead and we can make the other adjustments and make it look a lot better with a really good starting place now. So if you're doing any HDR, make sure you turn that option on. So let's straighten this photograph. So we go outside and we drag it. Now, one of the things you'll notice, it's only in-cropping. It's not out-cropping. So if I undo that and we enable expand, and now when we straighten this image, notice it enables us to out-crop into these areas. Well, one of the nice things is we can use generative expand in here. And notice that can expand it out. So we get three variations. And we can choose the variation that we like the best, and then just choose keep. And at this point, this works pretty well. There's a little bit of resolution mismatch on the corner there, but when we are straightening a photo, I think we can get away with this. However, when we're working on something larger, like say for example, here's a panorama. In fact, this is an HDR panorama. Notice we've got all the transparency around the edge here, which is a byproduct of a panorama. But watch this, if we choose to crop it here, and we enable expand, and we choose generate, it is able to generate the outside. However, notice that it doesn't quite match. And that's because we've got a really large image and the resolution is not really large enough to kind of work on this panorama. So I would say watch this space, and maybe this is a feature in the future that might work well for panoramas. But for now, it's working pretty good for straightening photos. And let's say if we wanted to expand this photo a little bit, we could as well, just to kind of show you the capabilities. And then we hit generate. Notice that generative expand is able to expand the photograph. And we can look at the variations. I think the first one is the best. A little bit of an issue there, but we could fix that with the remove tool. If you're outputting to low resolution, such as social media, you could definitely get away with the generative expand. But if you're doing anything high resolution or anything printing, it's not quite ready for you yet. So the generative remove has had some new features added to it. So let's have a look right now. We're going to go to the remove tool, and then we're going to choose the generative AI, and we're going to choose select objects. So one of the new features is the ability to circle select. So if we want to select something, we can just make a circle around it. Notice it will automatically select it. And then we can just choose remove. And if you want to hide the overlay, we can just go there. Looks pretty good. Let's turn our overlay back on. And this time we want to scribble select. So let's just make a scribble selection around there. Notice that also knows what we're trying to select. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. If there's some areas you want to protect, we can just choose the subtract option. And I'm just using the bracket key, the square bracket key, to change the size of the brush. And I just want to be careful that we don't remove that area there. So you could go in a little bit tighter just to kind of protect some of these areas if you wanted. And then when we're ready, we're just going to choose remove. Let's hide the overlay so we can see. That looks pretty good. Now you get three variations, so we could choose a second variation or a third variation. I think I like that second variation the best. You'll want to avoid this for larger areas in the image just because the resolution is lower. However, for small areas like this, this is going to work fine. As long as the area that you are replacing is smaller, around about 1,000 pixels, you're going to have no problems with the resolution mismatch. However, we couldn't remove something large like this arch and not have a low resolution insert in there. Thanks for checking this out. Let me know in the comments underneath, what was your favorite new feature inside of Camera Raw? By the way, I'm going to be doing another one on Lightroom soon. I've already done one on the new features in Photoshop 2025. Check it out right there. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit that subscribe button. Turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.